There's concern tonight over removing a longtime gateway to the open water in the South Cape. City leaders approved a plan to get rid of the decades-old Chiquita boat lock at Cape Harbor. NBC2's George Solis is live right now from the lock with more on this heated debate. George.
That's right, Kelly. Two major concerns at play here. One, the environment. Two, convenience. Now, some feel that the lock's removal is a win-win for both.
For Cape Coral boater Gary Arth, there's no love lost for the Chiquita Lock.
Purpose of it, I don't know. I can't see where it's really doing anything.
Except for one thing, a common complaint out here at Cape Harbor.
Restricting and backing boats up, boat traffic sometimes.
Harbor Master Frank Muto believes that's the epicenter of this long-standing debate to remove the lock.
It's there or it's not there. You have an hour run just to get to where the lock is because it's all no-wake zone.
But that's not the main problem. He fears the lock's removal's impact to tidal flows will mean bad business for him and boat owners.
So if we lose 4.5 feet of water in that marina, those 65-foot boats are all of a sudden going to be sitting on their $5,000 propellers.
Concerns we took to council member Rena Erbrick.
You know, we do have a dredging master plan that sets out there, so that is something you can address.
As for environmental concerns, Erbrick says many of the issues associated with poor water quality are now a non-issue now that many of the homes in the South Cape are running city water and sewer.
The water ahead of that lock, you know, behind the lock, is actually in better shape and better quality than the stuff that is coming down the river.
But no plans are on official lockdown until the FDEP approves the permits when and if to remove the lock once and for all.
I don't think it's really going to hurt anything, tell you the truth.
Now, we did reach out to the DEP today for comments on this issue. We have not heard back. Meanwhile, we have learned that the city has hired an engineering firm for their proposal on plans to remove the lock once and for all. Reporting live in Cape Coral, George Solis, NBC2.